buddy.
Where's the sister note?
Well, what's going on?
Get down, Edgar.
You still owe me a dollar.
I don't owe you anything, but we'll be all right.
$1.
You're just moving right along. Hey, Chief, you excited to join us, huh?
We have the dog to keep you company. No,
that was good as you. I got it. Chief, you just go ahead and leave the sister note.
Oh, yeah.
What about my sister? It's SL-1 again.
Okay, man. Suit up.
Chief, come on, Chief. Come on, Chief.
Enough. Suit up. Edgar. See another false alarm.
They said they're looking into it.
Well, good, because we can't keep doing this. Not for the worth of SL-1, anyway. Now, if it was one of them Sicard Navy reactors, that'd be a different story.
What do you mean by worthless?
Atomics consider the SL-1 real mop-up duty out here. Not only that, evidently has all sorts of problems. Riley's neighbor works there, and he's scared to death of the thing.
What's it for, anyway?
Something about providing power for radar stations in the Arctic Circle. SL-1 stands for stationary. I'm listening.
They're still not answering their phone. If the HPs are on their way, too.
Okay, thanks, Elena. We'll check it out. Check it out. Fire department. Hello.
Well, there's our food. They must still be here.
High rad level.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
Oh. She can't be right. It's pegged.
Go call Elena. Tell her to radio HQ. Tell her the decimeter's reading off the scale.
All right.
You know, a reading this high, it's about to have an automatic response. Roadblocks. Medicals. This place is about to be swarmed in HPs.
Go check the reactor room.
Right.
You know what? I'm sick of hearing it. Yeah, it's not working. It's not working because you nag me all the time.
Set the drive motor retract to 4 inches. Step 6.
Yeah, you're always putting me on a guilt trip. But that's bull.
Next, remove the drive motor attachment pin from the motor assembly mount.
You want to move out.
Where's my paycheck? Fine. You know what? Fine. You want a divorce? Fine. See if I care. Arlene?
Step 6. Rotate the shield plug attachment until the holes in the L bracket line up with the... Hey, John.
Ah, Burns! Nice for you to join us.
Screw you. What? You heard me.
I don't think I like your attitude, mister.
I don't think I like your attitude, mister. I don't really care what you like or you don't like. And if you don't like it, you and I can step outside.
Shoot. You and how many of your friends?
Guys, take it easy.
You stay out of this, Junior.
First of all, I'm not gonna step outside with you. At least not right now. Second of all, you need to store it, mister. You understand me, Corporal? We've got another uncooperative control rod which seems to be sticking, which we need to attach the drive motor to it. So, listen to me, very carefully. I need you to lift that another quarter inch so I can attach a C-clamp to it.
Fine. 1/4 inch, coming right up.
Looks like some sort of explosion. The place is destroyed.
What about the three techs?
Well, we only saw two. One guy's definitely dead. The other guy isn't moving, but he's moaning. We're fixing to go get him right now.
You can't.
Why not?
The radiation's too high.
Forget the radiation. We're not just gonna leave him there.
No, look, I know how you feel, but he's gonna be dead in a matter of minutes anyway. And you're gonna be dead in a few days if you go in there for any length of time.
We're not just gonna leave him there. I'm not gonna have to tell his family that he was still alive, moaning to us to help him, and we just stood around and did nothing. Man!
I forbid you go in there. Listen to me, the level of radiation is way too high. It's a death sentence.
Man.
No, listen. Chief, this is what we're gonna do, okay? We're gonna go in there in one-man teams, 15 seconds, that's it. Whatever you can do in 15 seconds, fine, okay? Then you're gonna get out of there, all right? And there should be a third guy in there somewhere. Try to find him if you can. And when you hear the horn, that's your time to come back, all right? You gotta get out of there then. All right? How'd it go?
I cleared a path.
Did you find the other guy?
No.
Okay, you're next. 15 seconds, remember.
Well, I found the third guy.
How is he?
He didn't make it.
How's he doing?
I can't feel his pulse. I think he's gone. What's this?
I don't know. Roadblock.
What's going on?
Out of the car. Right now.
One sweetheart, out of the car, right now. Sir, out of the car, please.
He's dead.
What's going on?
What do you think?
I think they're gonna be okay, but we need to get him to decontamination right now.
Okay, right this way, please.
Right.
Oh, wait, my purse.
Forget your purse. Your purse is way too hot.
But it's got my keys and my rent and
Don't
everything.
Don't worry about that. We'll take care of it.
This way. You get him to decontamination.
I'll call headquarters.
Okay. Take it from here, you're done.
Okay, let's go.
Well now, hold on a second. First we gotta get you guys decontaminated.
What does that entail?
Where's Ben? Come on, where are you?
The sun is freezing!
There he is, God bless it.